Their matching green shirts and hats seem to symbolize they're all relatives, perhaps members of a family reunion, or maybe they're in a sorority. Sadly, they are in a club, but it is not one you would join willingly.
My mom passed from cancer.
My father died of cancer.
And it was my mother who had it. She had cervical cancer. My brother, he had cancer. He had prostate and bone cancer.
Because my mom had cancer. Initially, she had breast cancer. She was a breast cancer survivor for like 15 years. And then she ended up passing away with brain tumor.
And the women say the only thing that connects their families to these cancers is where they grew up, right here on Sheridan Place, during the late 50s and early 60s. They lived in apartment 6, 8, 10, you can see it's missing, 12 and 14. And the others lived around the corner on Orange Street in these homes. And embedded among their houses was this. It was called the State Powerhouse, and it burned coal. And when it burned coal, no one could escape it.
But they had no reason to escape it. They had no fear of danger.
There's an entrance there where the trucks used to come in. And so it was wide open to anyone. But there were the gates that came down. We played dodgeball, kickball, handball, you name it.
We used to roll around in the grass and play in the grass and everything, you know. So, like she said, this was a playground.
The coal-burning plant was built in the early 1900s to provide heat for the Capitol and the State Education Building. News Channel 13 obtained insurance maps from 1934 of that Albany plant. You can see the proximity of the plant to the women's homes.
You could see maybe little particles in the air, but as a child, you don't really pay attention to the particles because no one told you that it was harmful.
Dr. David Carpenter heads the Institute for Health and the Environment at UAlbany. His research focuses on diseases caused by environmental exposures. He says air pollution from coal produces carcinogens that can be linked to cancer.
Coal contains metals, and some of those metals cause cancer. The ones that are best documented are arsenic, cadmium.
Is if that power plant wasn't there, stationed in a residential community, would any of them still be here today?
Colon carcinoma, metastatic cancer of the bowel. Colorectal cancer, metastatic prostate cancer. Metastatic lung cancer, prostate cancer. Metastatic throat cancer, glioblastoma. These are death certificates News Channel 13 obtained from these women. They belong to their relatives. Over the years, they also began hearing about the deaths of friends who had moved away from the neighborhood.
And then the conversation started around that. You know, the discussion that people were getting sick, some had passed away.
Their concern turned to worry when some of them started getting sick too.
I'm also a breast cancer. I have breast cancer.
And their children.
I was diagnosed with cancer, passed down in the bloodline. My daughter's diagnosed with cancer.
Suspicious, they soon realized that the common denominator was this, the now closed State Powerhouse. It burned coal, and as children, they all lived near it. Had they been the victims of environmental racism?
Yes, their exposure would have been much greater than people that didn't live in the vicinity of all of the emissions coming from that plant.
Dr. David Carpenter researches diseases caused by environmental exposures. He heads the Institute for Health and the Environment at UAlbany.
But we certainly know that air pollution in general, these polyaromatic hydrocarbons, these carcinogenic metals, which we know are going to be in the emissions from a coal-fired plant. They cause cancer.
And he says there is reason for the women to be concerned not only about their children, but their grandchildren.
These chemicals do damage our DNA, and that becomes a way for multi-generational transmission of increased risk of disease.
The plant, built in the early 1900s, was created to provide heat to the state education department and the Capitol. News Channel 13 found an ad for bids for that coal plant in a 1911 document in Electric World. We also obtained these insurance blueprints from 1934, which shows the proximity of the plant to the homes. Albany has a history of dirty plants. In the 80s, the Answers plant, built just in front of that coal-burning one, burned trash and was railed on by environmentalists.
And at least set aside a trust fund, just in case my daughters or any children come down with any carcinogens or lung disease or ailments.
Even back then, black residents complained the tons of waste being burned there caused illnesses in their children, but they were told they had nothing to worry about.
What happens is that these polluting industries are often placed in communities where there's little political power.
The women are angry, questioning whether homes in more affluent neighborhoods would have ever been built near a coal plant.
Yeah, the landlords, when they built the houses, they wasn't thinking about us individually. They was thinking of themselves.
They're adamant this was a case of environmental racism. And Dr. Carpenter agrees.
That is absolutely correct. That's blatant environmental racism.
After soot fell on snow near the governor's mansion, the Answers plant was abruptly shut down in 1994. Elaine McCall says if only they had been as important as the then governor.
We were, I'd say, insignificant.